Hey y'all, welcome back and thanks for stopping by. In today's video, I have four adorable snowmen DIYs, so let's get started. For the first DIY, I used a 5-inch round glass vase from Walmart, a 5-inch candle plate also from Walmart, and a 4.5-inch candle dish from Hobby Lobby. The first thing I did was clean all the glass with rubbing alcohol. I then painted the bottom of the two candle dishes with Rust-Oleum hammered spray paint in black. I also painted the inside of the round vase using Krylon Fusion spray paint in gloss white. Once all the pieces were dry, I used clear grip glue from Gorilla Glue and some hot glue to assemble the candle holder. First, I attached the vase upside down on the 5-inch candle plate. I made sure to keep the two glues from mixing together because they don't like each other, and if they do happen to mix, they will create a gooey mess and nothing will adhere. I used the hot glue for an instant hold and the Gorilla Glue for a permanent hold. I also used the same combination of glues to adhere the 4.5-inch candle dish to the top of the vase. I used my Cricut to cut out a cute little snowman face out of permanent vinyl. If you don't have a Cricut, you could use stickers or hand paint the snowman's face onto the candle holder. To make a scarf, I cut a strip from a red and black buffalo check handkerchief from Hobby Lobby that was about 1.5 blocks wide. Then using hot glue, I folded the fabric in half so that it would be just the right size for the scarf and not cover up any of the snowman's facial features. Once the scarf was made, I used some hot glue to attach it around the neck of the snowman and then cut the ends so that they wouldn't be too long but you could still see them. And that's it for this one. It was quick and easy and I think it turned out absolutely adorable. Today's video is part of the Unusual Snowman DIY playlist. It's hosted by Amanda over at Six Kids and a Glue Gun and Mimi from Crafting in Mimi's World. I will leave links to their channels as well as to the playlist in the description box below for even more snowman inspiration. Moving into DIY number 2, I used another 5-inch round vase from Walmart, a 4.9-inch round vase, and a 3.5-inch round vase, both from Dollar Tree. I began by cleaning the inside of the 3.5-inch vase with some rubbing alcohol. Then I used Krylon Fusion spray paint in gloss white to paint the inside of the vase. To make a hat for the snowman, I used a black foam sheet, black craft felt, and a lid to a candle that was roughly the same size as I wanted the hat brim to be. I took the candle lid and traced around the largest side onto the black foam sheet and cut it out. Next, I traced the candle lid onto the black felt twice, once again using the largest side, and cut them out. Then, using hot glue, I glued the felt circles onto the foam circle. I sandwiched the foam piece between the two felt pieces. I used the foam to give some stability to the hat, but wanted the hat to look like it was felt, so I used felt to cover the foam. For the top of the hat, I used a foam pool noodle from Dollar Tree and measured out how tall I wanted the hat to be and used scissors to cut it to size. I did go back in with the scissors and try to cut the foam as level as possible so that it would sit flush on top of the hat base. Then I used the leftover black felt and hot glue to cover the pool noodle by wrapping the felt around the foam. I did not cover the part of the pool noodle that would be glued to the top of the hat base. I used as little glue as possible directly on the pool noodle to prevent the glue from melting the foam. The hot glue will melt the pool noodle some, but if you put the glue directly onto the felt and then put it onto the pool noodle, it doesn't melt as much. Even though the pool noodle does melt, it isn't noticeable once the hat is finished. Once the pool noodle was covered, I cut off the excess felt, getting it as even with the top of the pool noodle as possible. To cover the top of the pool noodle, I traced around it on a scrap piece of black felt and cut it out. I then used hot glue to glue it to the top of the pool noodle hat. I made sure the edges were glued down so that none of the green foam was showing. Once I had the hat completely covered with the felt, I went back in and cleaned up any felt that was sticking over the seam so that it would have a cleaner look. Then I used a generous amount of hot glue to attach the top of the hat to the base. Next, I took the same red and black buffalo check fabric from the first project and cut a strip 2 blocks wide. Then I folded it in half and used hot glue to create a scarf to go around the top of the hat. Once I had the scarf made, I used a little bit of hot glue to tack it in place while I wrapped it around the hat and tied a knot off to one side, letting the tails hang over the side just a little bit. Then I set the hat on the snowman's head and cut the scarf tails to the length I thought looked best. To give the hat a little bit of character, I dug around in my winter florals and found a small flocked pine branch and a small red poinsettia and hot glued them to the side of the hat. Once the hat was finished, I used hot glue to glue it to the top of the snowman's head. For the face of the snowman, I used my Cricut and cut out a smaller version of the same face from the first project since I wanted these two pieces to be cohesive. I also used my Cricut to cut out 4 buttons for the snowman. Again, you could paint on the face and buttons or use stickers if you don't have a Cricut or vinyl cutting machine. Next, I took another piece of red and black buffalo check, cut 2 blocks wide, and folded it over twice and hot glued it to make a scarf for the neck of the snowman. Since the snowman is going to be a tiered candy dish, I wanted the scarf to be just big enough to go around the mouth of the 4-inch vase and not cover the buttons or mouth when the head is in place. I used hot glue to attach the scarf to the top of the 4-inch vase. You can use a stronger adhesive if you want a more permanent hold. I used hot glue for video purposes. Once I had the scarf wrapped around the opening of the vase, I hot glued the 2 tails together so that it would have a more secure hold. Then I trimmed off the tails at a length I thought looked best. To finish off the candy jar, I filled the bottom tier with some kisses in a silver wrapper and the middle tier with kisses in a blue wrapper and stacked them back up in order. I didn't put any candy inside the head of the snowman since it was painted. I'm absolutely in love with how this one turned out and can't wait to display them in the kitchen this winter. For DIY number 3, I used a paperback book that I had on hand that I had already read and removed the front cover along with all the pages up to the start of the first chapter, as well as the back cover and the spine cover. I took a piece of paper and set the book on top of it, then traced around the book and cut it out. This will help me determine how big I can make the snowman. To create a template for the snowman, I placed a piece of paper inside the book and roughly sketched out the outline of a snowman shape and then cut it out. Once I had the template cut out, I placed it on top of the book so that the bottom of the snowman stopped close to the center of the page and traced it out. You don't want to make the snowman too wide or it won't look like a snowman at all. Trust me, it took me a couple of tries for me to figure it out. After I had traced the snowman onto the book page, I took a utility knife with a fresh sharp blade and cut along the snowman shape I had traced. I used a small amount of pressure to cut into a few pages at once. Once I finished cutting, I removed the section of the page I had cut off. Then I continue to repeat the step until I cut all the pages in the book. You do want to be careful when doing this so you don't cut yourself, and you don't want to try to cut more than a couple of pages at a time or they will rip. After I had all the pages cut, I set the snowman up and fluffed the pages so he would look nice and full. To make a scarf for the snowman, I took more of the red and black buffalo check fabric and started cutting about a half a block in, then ripped it the rest of the way so that it would have frayed edges. Then I took the scarf and tied it loosely around the neck of the snowman so that it wouldn't squeeze the pages back together and trimmed up the tails. After I had the scarf in place, I fluffed up the snowman and he was finished. I think this little guy turned out so cute. He was easy to make, but it did take a little bit of time to cut out all those pages. For DIY number 4, I used a foam football from Dollar Tree and painted it with 3 coats of Waverly chalk paint in the color white. For the base of the snowman, I used a black candle holder from Walmart. Once the paint was dry on the football, I used a utility knife and scissors to cut off one of the ends so that it would sit flat on the candle holder. I tried to get the end of the football as even as possible so that it would stand up straight when I stood it on the base. Once I had the end cut flat, I used a generous amount of hot glue to attach it to the candle holder. For the details on the snowman, I picked up a jar of buttons from Dollar Tree and picked out several that I thought would look best for his eyes, mouth, and buttons. I used a styrofoam carrot I had in my stash from Easter for his nose. I used hot glue to attach all the buttons and the carrot to create the eyes, nose, mouth, and buttons. I did not have any issue with the foam of the football melting under the buttons or carrot as long as I didn't apply the glue directly to the football. I have to give credit for this DIY to my 13-year-old son who suggested I make a snowman out of a football. We are a football-loving family, so it just felt right and I thought it was very unusual. I've never seen a snowman made out of a football before. To make the scarf, I once again used the same red and black buffalo check fabric and ripped off a small piece and hot glued it around the neck of the snowman, making sure not to cover up his mouth or buttons. I tied it in a knot on one side and cut the tails to a length I liked. For the arms of the snowman, I went out in the yard and picked up 2 sticks that were similar in shape and thickness. Once I decided how long I wanted the arms to be, I cut the sticks to size and then tried to get them to match as much as possible. Once I had them cut to size, I pushed them into the foam just enough to make a hole and then used some hot glue to glue them into place. I made a hat for this snowman using the same technique I used in DIY number 2, but to decorate this hat, I used a piece of flocked pine and 2 pieces of a red berry pick. Once the hat was finished, I used hot glue to glue it to the snowman's head. To finish off this project, I took some spider webs from Dollar General and used hot glue to glue some around the bottom of the snowman to help cover up where I glued him to the base and to make it look like he's standing in snow. I'm absolutely in love with how this snowman turned out. This one has to be my favorite project in today's video. Let me know in the comments below which project was your favorite and if you're looking forward to this upcoming holiday season. Here's the final reveal of today's projects. I really do love them all and they really put me in a mood for a snow day. Don't forget to check out the playlist in the description box below to get more unusual snowman inspiration and check out the host as well. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a big thumbs up. It really helps out my channel. And if you haven't hit that subscribe button yet, what are you waiting for? Click that button and stick around for a while. I'll see y'all next time.